guys, my name is Sabine and welcome to another video. Today I have a very exciting Booktube-A-Thon 2017 wrap-up because I actually did quite well in this read-a-thon. Last year I tried to participate as well. I failed miserably because the Booktube-A-Thon was before my trip to America, so I had to pack and do all tons of things, but right now I had a week just working and reading and it was so great. So I'm gonna show you guys the four books that I finished and the fifth book that I started. So before I'm gonna start this wrap-up, I just want to quickly thank you guys for 1700 subscribers. I'm so just happy that you all subscribe to my channel, that you all seem to like my videos. I hope that you do. And when I will hit 2,000 subscribers, I will definitely do a giveaway. So 300 subscribers more to go, and then you guys will have a giveaway. And before I will start my wrap up, I just want to quickly mention something that I usually mention at the end of my videos. If you guys want to follow me on my social media pages, I have Goodreads, which will probably be very interesting for you guys if you want to keep up with what I'm reading and stuff like that. Plus, I'm also very active on my Bookstagram lately, which is the same as my channel name, Sabine's Book Nook. So go check that out if you want. I also have a personal Instagram, Snapchat, and an email address, so you guys can do whatever you want with that. I will just have my social media pages in the description down below, so go check it out. Okay, so right now, let's start with wrapping up all the books that I read for the Booktube-A-Thon 2017. So the first book is Roar by Cora Carmack, and I picked this book for the challenge of read a book with a person on the cover. I was still reading this before the Booktube-A-Thon started, so I was at like page 280 out of 380. On Booktube-A-Thon day one, I read 100 pages to finish this, so I did not completely like start this. I'm just such a slow reader, so for me this was already an accomplishment. This is like a fantasy book about people who are able to control storms, and it was really awesome. I really enjoyed it, but this book in total took me a month to read, and I read like one third of the book in one day, so I just didn't, it wasn't 100% what I wanted this book to be. The story was still very interesting. The world is super interesting. I really liked the group of characters that we were introduced to. And I also really liked Cora Carmack's writing style. But for some reason, whenever I read like 30 pages, I wasn't like, ooh, I want to read another chapter. So something was missing, but I will be continuing this series, I think. And I gave this one like a 3.75 out of 5 stars just because something wasn't there that I wanted, but I just cannot like pinpoint what it was. So on Booktube-A-Thon day two, I went shopping as well, and I went to this English YA, well, not per se YA, but just like this English bookstore that is very near my hometown, which I didn't even know was there. So now my whole world is like opened up again. I do have like a bookstore in my town, but it's mostly Dutch, and the YA English section is just so super duper small, and the books are so expensive that I just don't go there, which I know is kind of bad because I do want to like support local bookshops, but I also want to support my wallet. And I'm not doing it by visiting that bookshop then. But I had gotten a gift card for this English bookshop, and I bought 3 books, and 2 of them I read during the Booktube-A-Thon. The first one is Attack on Titan by Hajime Ishiyama, and I don't know what challenge this would fit because I just picked it up. So this is super different from what I have ever, like, in my entire life read. This is a manga. And if you're kind of familiar with mangas, you already know that this book just itself is super different, and you can already tell because normally you would read a book like this, and a manga you have to read it from like the back is what we would say. Plus you also have to read from right to left and not from left to right, so that was already a change that I needed to get used to. But it's also like a graphic novel, you know, it's like a manga, so that was already a super different format. I've always been interested in reading graphic novels, but I just never really had the chance or didn't really pick the chance to buy and read one because they are quite expensive. Like this one was 10 euros and I probably could have read this in like 3 hours. So paying 10 euros for 3 hours of entertainment is quite expensive, I would say. And I really enjoyed it. It is a very action-packed manga, but there are 23 volumes and I'm not seeing myself spending another 220 euros on mangas. That would be a little bit ridiculous, but I still really enjoyed this one. I gave it like a 4 out of 5 stars. It was a very different experience. It was a very fun experience, and I've already bought another manga in a manga series, so that will be in my August book haul. The only reason why I'm not giving it like 5 stars is just it was action-packed, but you were just kind of like thrown into the world, so that was something that you kind of needed to get used to. Plus, because it's manga, like the drawings are sometimes very sketchy, like I cannot really tell what was going on sometimes in the story, which is not really that great, but still, it looks just really awesome, and I hope that all of the mangas that I will be reading in the future will be just as good as this one. During reading Attack on Titan, I also read The Vincent Boys by Abby Glines, my second actual book, just normal book that I read, and I had picked this up twice before, read until like page 70 and really did not enjoy it, but right now I was going to get through this. The thing is, Abby Glines' writing style is super easy to get through. It is like a very chick lit, romance heavy novel, and I still didn't enjoy it after I finished it. Like, the story itself is like maybe a 2, 2.5 out of 5 stars. The writing style is very quick and easy to get through, so that is what helped me through the story. So this story is mainly focused on Ashton and Bo, and they both have, like, Ashton has a perfect boyfriend who's called Sawyer, and Sawyer is Bo's nephew, and Bo also has a girlfriend, but during the summer, Sawyer is gone, and she sort of like reunites with Bo because they have been friends in the past, but they haven't talked in a while. And Ashton and Bo sort of like rekindle their friendship, during the summer, and they immediately fall in love again. It's like, oh my god. It's like insta-love all over again, but apparently they have always loved each other and and they cheat. Like, I just really did not like the cheating aspect of this book. If that wasn't in the story would have already been so much better in my opinion if there was just like some sort of like impossible thing for their relationship. It was just a quick read in between, but it's like you read it and then you forget it. That's what kind of story this is. And I picked this book for the 7th challenge, which is read 7 books. I did not do that, but this was just a random book that I picked. And then the 4th book that I finished during the Booktube-A-Thon, it's not actually a book, it's a graphic novel, and that is Lumberjanes by Stevenson, Ellis, Waters, and Allen. I only know Noelle Stevenson because she like drew and made Nimona, which I also ordered for my book haul. This is volume number 1, which is called Beware the Kitten Holy, and it was such a fun, cute graphic novel. And this completes the challenge of read a book in a day, because I finished this within like 1 or 2 hours, I think. I really, really, really love the art style in this one. I don't know, it's just so pretty, and the characters are so much fun too, especially Ripley, who's right here. She's such a silly character, and I feel like there's also like a little bit maybe female romance in it. Like, these two characters are very like together always, and I don't know if it's like if they're like in love with each other, but maybe I shall find out in the next volumes, because I do want to continue on with this graphic novel series. It just was a ton of fun. This is like about a friend group, these 5 girls who go to summer camp, and during the summer camp they do really awesome stuff. There are monsters involved, like little quests and stuff like that. It is such a shame that graphic novels are so expensive. Otherwise, if it would have been a lot cheaper, I would have definitely already bought like volume 2 to 6, because this one was so much fun and I gave it like a 4 out of 5 stars. And then book number 5 was the book that I chose for pick a book that you bought for the cover. I definitely did not finish it, but it is City of Ashes by Cassandra Clare, and this is what I've read. It's not much, but it is 72 pages out of the 411, and I really want to continue on with the Mortal Instruments series by Cassandra Clare. This is my first time reading it. I know, guys, major, major shock. I do think that I've forgotten so many details from City of Bones, because I read that one last year and I thought that I still knew pretty much like a lot, but I started reading this one and I constantly was like, oh my god, did that happen in the first book? I don't remember anything about it, but I will just continue reading this and hopefully I will just get back into the story again, because right now I'm kind of not really into like the Mortal Instruments world and I just really want to get back in it. These were like the 4 or 5 books that I read during the Booktube-a-thon. This was a really like successful week for me. Right now I will count the amount of pages that I've read, and keep in mind only 2 of these that I actually, or like 3 of these that I actually picked up are normal books. During this week I read 747 pages, which is a lot more than I've read in the past couple of months, because I've been kind of in a reading slump. myself, but I definitely feel that because of this Booktube-A-Thon, I've been really like in a reading mood again. So I'm really happy about that. Let me know in the comments down below if you participated as well and how many things that you read. Was the week successful for you? I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, please give it a thumbs up and subscribe to my channel to see more of my videos, and I will see you guys in the next one. Bye!